I said stop running.
No, no me agarre. No me agarre.
Stop running.
Whoa. This is an intense one, man. This is pretty good. It's a real quick video, but yeah, it's got some intense action, though. So, guys, thanks for tuning in. Check this out here. I got something, man, to watch as far as the NYPD and the basically a lot of what's going on right now. I am going to say something here at the end of this video that it's just going to be my opinion. Okay, it's my speculation, but due to the current situation, what's going on in New York, Chicago, LA, all over, you know, I mean, Philly, Baltimore, I mean, you might see it. You might see it, what I'm talking about here, but let me bring this video in, man, and watch. This is nuts.
What's wrong with you? I said stop running.
No, no me agarre. No me agarre.
Stop running.
Hold up. Start spitting out Spanish. Okay. Right off the giddy up. Okay. Now, I'm not trying to talk over this too much though, but right off the rip, I would say you running barefoot at 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm gonna read the rest of the details to this, so man, and this you can pretty much speculate where I'm going with this.
Give me your fucking. Grab the gun. You got it? You got this? Grab the gun.
Yeah. Give me your hands. Just clench his back.
Give me your fucking.
Right there.
Yeah. Get it away.
I've been hit.
Me too.
I've been hit.
Oh, man. Oh, that's intense, dude. That's crazy. Like I said, that video was quick. But I saw this and I said, let me make a video about this real quick, because that situation right there, honestly, either one of those cops right there, man, they could have put bullets in the back of that dude's dome, man, and been justified to do so. Okay? And would have walked. So I'm sitting here wondering, I'm like, all right, I'm thinking, okay, shot dude in the foot to get him to drop the gun. Why didn't he just, he could have ended him. I'm just thinking, why come he just didn't end that dude right there? He'd have been justified to do so. Seriously. I'm completely in self-defense. Both of them were shot at point blank range by that dude here. And you know what? Let me bring up the details here as far as the description. And let me read the description here so you can break it down here, because this happened a couple months ago back here in June. So it says Queens, New York, on Monday, June 3rd, 2024, at approximately 1:38 a.m., NYPD police officers Christopher Abreu, Officer Richard Yaruso, and Sergeant Nicholas Condos observed 19-year-old Bernardo Castro Mata operating unregistered motorcycle against the flow of one-way traffic and without wearing a helmet in the vicinity of, was it, Ditmars Boulevard and 90th Street, Queens. The officers attempted to stop Castro Mata. However, Castro Mata abandoned the scooter and fled on foot. Officer Abreu, Officer Iruso, and Sergeant Condos pursued Castromonte and caught up with him up opposite, what is that, 88? Jesus, maybe I should put my glasses on. 88-08 23rd Avenue, where the struggle ensued. During the struggle, Mata removed firearm from his crossbody bag and shot Officer Iruso in the lower chest at point-blank range. The officer's bullet-resistant vest stopped the bullet, thank God. Okay. Mata was shot. Also shot Officer Abreu, striking him in the upper right thigh area. As a result, Officer Abreu discharged 4 shots, shooting Castromonte in the foot and the ankle area, at which point... at which point the defendant let go of the firearm and was placed in handcuffs. Ballistics evidence recovered from the scene revealed that Castromonte discharged at least 3 shots from his firearm. Castromonte was transported from the scene via ambulance in New York Presbyterian Church. Presbyterian. That's why I need to put my glasses on. Oh, Jesus. Sucks when you get old. Queens, where he was treated for his injuries. Officer Abreu and Officer Iruso were transported to Elmhurst Hospital Center, where they were both treated and for the gunshot wound. Police recovered a loaded high point throwaway gun, .380 caliber pistol at the scene, as well as 2 deformed fired bullets, 9mm fragments, 3 discharged .380 caliber shell casings, and 4 9mm discharge shell casings. For his actions, Castromonte was arrested and charged with attempted murder in the first degree, a police officer in second degree, attempted assault in the first degree, assault with second degree, criminal possession of weapon, loaded firearm, and related charges. So, like I said, man, dude, I'm gonna tell you straight up, look, that situation right there, like I said, them cops could have put one, they could have put 2 in the back of his dome, 1 or 2 in the back of that dude's dome and be done with him, okay, at that point. Shots fired on 2 officers, both of them struck. Yeah. Why I'm asking this question, I said, this is intense. And then I thought about it, I'm like, well, how come they just didn't off this dude? They would have been justified to do so by far. I mean, return fire, self-defense, and just off this dude. And I'm thinking... well, if you do that, then the rest of the protocol comes into effect as far as administrative leave, you know, while there's an investigation and everything. So I'm just, I'm thinking at the time when dude got hit, he's like, I don't know if I want to be off work because you don't know if it's going to be paid administrative leave. Usually something like this in a self-defense situation, probably get paid administrative leave, you know, until the investigation is over and then be back on the force doing what they do. So I'm thinking, dude didn't want to off him possibly because of that. So you bust him in the leg and the foot, get him to drop the gun. And I'm going to tell you straight up, those shots right there in that ankle and that foot, that dude is going to feel that for the rest of his life. His ankle is screwed for the rest of his life. No matter how much surgery you do on it, he's going to have a problem with his foot and his ankle for the rest of his life with shots like that. I mean, point blank range, rip right through that ankle joint, right there through it. I'm telling you straight up, he's going to have, I would be... highly, highly shocked if that dude did not have a limp for the rest of his life or even a partial limp. I'm just saying, because that's devastating. And you know officers are carrying defense rounds too. So those defense rounds, you know, those hollow points, man, are either hollow points or hydro shocks. Either one, boom, you know, ripping right through that ankle, man. Oh, dude, even at point blank range right there. Yeah, that's going to do some damage, man. That's tearing that stuff up big time. Drop that gun, though. But anyway, like I said, quick video. I'm not trying to drag it out too much, though. But I just like, oh, man, let me talk about this for a minute. Because, like I said, I was wondering. I'm like, dude, how come they just didn't off this dude? And I'm like, okay. I can speculate a few things, you know. But like I said, I'm speculating just allegedly that this dude was an illegal. Because New York has a serious illegal immigrant problem, big time. And unregistered scooter, motorcycle, sure is a scooter, this and that. This is very, very common as far as it you see in Venezuela, El Salvador, Brazil, everything. I mean, these vehicles are just common, just every day. Even though here they're common too, but I'm just saying it's almost, it's weird. I've seen so many videos of thieves, you know, any kind of like I said, crooks in third world countries, man. It's like, it always seems like these guys are always running around with scooters or something like that. Probably because it's just an easy machine to get. So, but it just, it's just that way. It's either scooters, man, motorcycles, you know, low-end motorcycles or whatever. I'm just saying it seems like the vehicle of choice to me because I've seen so many of them and it always seems to come back to that theme over and over and over. Every time the getaway vehicle, most of the time, you know, half of them would operate in fashions like this. And on top of that, old boys running around barefoot too. I'm just like, all right, whatever. But I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Guys, let me know in the comments below. Let me know what you think, man. How intense was that? Was that something to get some pointers off of, though? Because it just tells you how south things can go, how quick, you know, trying to arrest this dude. There's no way they can check the bag. He reaches in that bag that quick. That's just how fast things can turn that fast, man, where two cops could have lost their life just for something like that off of one individual, you know. And as I said, for that dude, you better be thanking the Lord above because he wouldn't be here. Literally, those cops could have ended him. And it'd have been 100% justified. Be right back out in the street, patrolling the streets again, man. So, anyway, let me know what you think. I will be back here with another one here. All right? And, guys, you can stay safe. Check me out. Let me know also if you guys want me to do some live stuff because I'm ready to do some live stuff here because it actually helps me out quite a bit here as far as the editing process for this. So, let me know. Get some calls going, different things here, probably like a weekend thing. Who knows? Just let me know down in the comments below. All right, guys, stay safe. I'll see you on the next one.